Hi everyone, Tatianka Allen here. I am a stage 3 bowel cancer survivor, a wellness and health coach. And I'm here today to talk about what I apply on my skin. When I was diagnosed with cancer and I started reading about health, I came across everything that it's kind of skin related products. And there was an enormous amount of information out there that talked about how many chemicals they're in products these days, and once we put that on our skin, is absorbed to our body, and our body needs to detoxify from those chemicals. So first off, I stopped using everything that I used to wear. I stopped wearing a body lotion, any nail polish, anything in my hair, unless it was like shampoo, really. I don't even wear conditioning anymore. Bear in mind, I kind of lost my hair during chemotherapy, so I didn't even have to use that. So that was actually quite simple. But once I started getting back to having to wash my hair, I only wear shampoo now. And I am really careful about the products that I buy in the supermarket. I look for things that have got no fragrance, no parabens, no SLS, and lots of the kind of the chemical components that we know that is harmful to ourselves. So I have a dear friend of mine that sells the Terra product, and she's been really generous with me in the last 3 years, explaining to me everything that she had been learning in her journey. And about a couple of months ago, we went on a trip to the outback in Australia where we experienced a different weather. It was very dry, and also the water was very different because it was bowl water. So my skin went very, very, very dry, a little like it was before cancer. Bear in mind, when we were out there, we were cooking our meals, we were only eating, you know, kind of same plant-based meals. And I was really surprised how quickly my skin went from being normal and in balance to very, very dry. Like my legs were like, you know, the skin was kind of peeling a bit, and the heels on my feet were cracked, and I hadn't had any problems with my skin since I had started changing all my diet. And now my skin has been really, really good in the last 2 years. And I would say that that's also to do with I drink a carrot juice every day, and I wasn't drinking the carrot juice when I was out in the back. So, you know, carrot juice is really good for your skin, and I have experienced an enormous amount of benefits from drinking, you know, one big glass of carrot juice every day. But all of a sudden, I realized that I needed to do something to support my skin, and it's something that has been on the back of my mind, but I always kind of put on the back burner, and I always thought this is kind of too hard. I haven't got time to be making my own products and to adding more time in my morning routine and in my evening routine. So I kind of was giving excuses, really, and I was kind of thinking that I just could do without adding any products. But the reality is, all of a sudden, my skin was screaming for help, because my skin was very, very dry, and I needed to help my skin get back into balance. And previous to going out to the outback, I kind of had made a decision that I was going to start getting myself more familiar with the doTERRA products and how I could make my own products as well. So everything happened in synchronicity, because on the way back from the outback, I stopped in my friend's house, who lives close by but not in the same city as I live, and I had already asked her to get me some stuff together so I could start making my morning and my evening facial cream or lotion or whatever you want to call it. So today I have here, I'm going to share you the recipe that I have been using. I have been using this recipe now for, you know, since then, a couple of months now. And my skin is doing really well on it. I am really enjoying it. The evening one, it's more oily base, and the morning one, it's more, you know, it's less oily. So I've got here four oils, frankincense, geranium, myrrh, and lavender. So each oil has got its own property, you know, and those essential oils, if you're familiar with it, they have some physical and some emotional properties as well. So I'm just going to talk you through, this is the 100 mils little spray bottle that I use to add the oils, and just to, you know, just to, I spray, you know, maybe two or three squirts every night, and then I apply to my face. And that is, you know, everything that I use. And I've got here the three carrier oils for this recipe, which is vitamin E oil, a jojoba oil, and rosehip oil. So just, you know, talking a little bit about each oil, like, you know, the frankincense, and that's 10 drops that you're going to be adding to, you know, straight to the bottle. And the only reason why I'm not doing that now is because I was making a video, and I realized that there was a fly on the video, so apologizes that I'm not making it together with you, but this is what I've just made in this bottle here. So I add straight to the bottle like that. It's easy and simple, you know, I don't need to use the funnel to add the oils. So frankincense is 10 drops, and you know, frankincense has got properties to help, like wounds and you know, open wounds or wrinkles, and it's really kind of regenerative support, skin regeneration. So it's a really beautiful oil. You've got here, and also on the emotional side of it, frankincense, and it supports, you know, meditation and prayer and focus. If that's is something that you, you know, you want to you know, help with as well. We've got geranium. Geranium is a skin moisturizer and helps skin hydration. So I have added 10 drops of geranium oil, and geranium has some detoxifying properties as well. We've got myrrh, which is a very earthy, is a thicker oil. So it takes a little longer to get out of the bottle, but again, I went straight into the bottle, and that is for dry skin and fine lines. So that is, I added 5 drops of that. And lavender, I've added 5 drops as well, and it's healing, cleansing, and soothing, and it's calming as well. Now, sometimes I add that to my bath as well, the kids' bath, which is beautiful. And I add 1/2 teaspoon of jojoba oil. In actual fact, I don't even put on a teaspoon. I go straight into the to the bottle, and I you know, it's not very liquidy, so we've got enough time to you know, to allow the oil to come out, and just to kind of to measure in your head, 1/2 teaspoon, and then 1/2 teaspoon of rose hip oil as well. And this one comes, I bought this in the supermarket with drops, a dropper, so it's really easy as well to add straight. And the only time that I used the funnel was to add the vitamin E oil, and the vitamin E oil was 1/2 teaspoon as well. And so 1/2 teaspoon of vitamin E, 1/2 teaspoon of rose hip, and sorry, the rest of the bottle was, I added jojoba oil. The vitamin E oil is moisturizing and nourish the skin, and the rosehip oil is full of antioxidants, so it's a beautiful oil, and it's, you know, really tissue and cell, you know, helps the tissue and cell regeneration. And the jojoba oil has got lots of healing properties as well. And you know, there is lots of products that skin products that have jojoba oil for that reason. So that is it, guys. So I'll add the recipe below, but it's not that hard. Once you have all the oils there, it takes me probably 5 minutes to put it all together. This has lasted me probably for about 6 weeks, or maybe even longer. I only apply at night, and I have a different one for the morning, and I'll make a video of that. So, you know, if you need any help, you know, please let me know. I'm also selling doTERRA products on my website. You can have a look at it. And if you need, you know, any help around that, please let me know as well. And I hope that you can get encouraged by this video to make your own products. You know, it's, again, it's like choosing instead of buying a ready-made meal, it's choosing to know exactly what's going on to your skin, and choosing the ingredients that you are adding to your body. So it's the same principle. You know, I realize now that my skin is part of my body, and I need to take care of my skin, and I need to give my skin the attention and the love that it needs. You know, our skin is our first kind of defense from everything from the outside. So I believe that, you know, I'm doing the right thing here for me, you know, not adding any chemicals and knowing exactly what I'm adding to my skin as well. So I hope this video is helpful. If you think that it's helpful, give me a thumbs up. And if you need any help around only essential oils, but, you know, really changing small habits so you can start creating a healthy life physically, emotionally, and spiritually, you know, I would love to hear from you. Help people to make small changes that compound into a massive impact in their physical, emotional, spiritual health, just like I did. So if you are ready to invest in your health and to really put the effort and the love and the care in, I would love to hear from you. Take care. See you later.